The Land Transportation Office bracing for the All Saints Day and All Souls Day holidays. The agency met with several transport groups Monday as it prepares for the influx of passengers. The LTO reminds transport hubs personnel to ensure health measures will be observed.
Hindi pa na naalis po yung mga health protocols na pinatutupad ng ating gobyerno. Andun pa rin po yun, yung mask, yung vaccine card, kailangan po may pakita para isa po sa mga mithiin natin dito ay ma-provide natin na healthy ang lahat. So, andun pa rin yun po. Tingin ko lang po ang ating mga terminal at mga kawani na nangangasiwa doon ay aware po sa ganitong mga alituntunin.
Small businesses urged to take advantage of the digitalization shift to boost their operations as well as the Philippine economy. Jackie Pascual now joins us for more details. Jackie?
Hi, Denise. Hundreds of entrepreneurs trooped to the Digital Sign Up Now Summit in Pasay, organized by Go Negosyo. The summit aims to help small and medium-sized enterprises expand their businesses with the help of digitalization or the online world. Several speakers share their success story, how they use social media and the internet in general to get better sales. Go Negosyo founder Joey Concepcion says it is not enough to just post your product on social media site or even an online shopping platform. There must be proper marketing styles and promotional strategies to further make one's product or services more attractive. Concepcion, whose family owns a large corporation, says even he himself is learning from the young speakers, asserting that big businesses, too, must adapt to the new changes in marketing. The U.S. Embassy in Manila and the Philippine Department of Information and Communication Technology representatives were also present at the summit, and they both say that the digital economy is expected to further expand, and this will create more jobs for Filipinos if we are prepared and ready for it. And that's the latest. Back to you, Denise.
Thanks for that, Jackie.
Hundreds of passengers stranded at the Mactan-Cebu International Airport after a Korean airplane overshot the runway. The airport's management said the incident involving Korean Air Flight KE631 happened late Sunday evening as it attempted to land amid heavy rain. All 162 passengers and 11 crew on board were immediately evacuated. No injuries were reported. The runway will be closed until October 25th to remove the aircraft. The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines is investigating the incident. The Tourism Department also in close coordination with relevant agencies to assist affected travelers.
The president of Korean Air apologizes for the runway mishap involving one of its jets. Ki Hong-woo also said they will conduct a thorough investigation with Philippine aviation authorities and their Korean counterparts to determine the cause of the incident. He added the airline will implement necessary measures to prevent it from happening again.
Meanwhile, flag carrier Philippine Airlines assures assistance for their passengers affected by that plane mishap in Cebu. PAL says they can avail of a variety of options like flight rescheduling or filing for a refund.
Maaari po silang mag-rebook within 6 days from their original flight date. At walang ipapataw na rebooking service fee. Maaari po silang mag-reroute. Maaari po silang mag-refund. Maaari po silang mag-convert ng kanilang ticket into travel credit. And in exchange, they will be given a travel voucher which they can use within 60 days, within 1 year from date of issuance.
Several flights of AirAsia have also been disrupted. Its spokesperson says the company is coordinating with affected passengers.
Meron din tayong nasa hanggang 5 flights na kinansela. Ito po yung Z2904, ito yung Manila-Cebu, yung Z2550 Cebu-Katiklan, Z2551 Katiklan-Cebu, Z2512 Cebu-Cagayan, at yung Z2511 Cagayan-Cebu. So itong mga flights po na ito ay kinansela na po natin. Gawa po ng, syempre kinakailangan din po nating i-rotate ng maayos yung ating mga eroplano. Ibig sabihin, mabigyan po ng maayos na schedule.
The Philippine government, meanwhile, vows to help migrant workers affected by the incident.